I'm Sophia. I'm the youngest sister of the three sisters in the Dagmar trio.
And I'm the oldest sister. It's actually 16 years in between us. And Christina, she is the designer, and she's not here today, unfortunately. And we started actually around 2005, the first collection. So this is the sixth year.
Yeah.
We are in the business, and
it's about the, I think, the fourth collection we're here showing in London now. And yeah, we have some great new accounts like Harrods and Shopper Bluebird that we're selling to here, so.
We named it after her because she was such a lovely person, and she took care of us a lot when we were small, and she was actually a tailor, and she was sewing a lot, and so that was what we did when we were spending time with her. We were cutting patterns and sewing, and she taught us how to knit and all those.
And she taught us a lot about qualities, and that should be very important in your wardrobe. She didn't have much money, but she always looked very, very chic. She had like matching glove and hat and bag, but she kind of went down to the flea markets and bought the fabrics and made her small kind of Chanel suits and looked very chic. So this, we can try to implement this into the company as well, to have this quality-wise that we think it's more important maybe to buy one item than many that are not so good in quality. Keeps long in the closet.
Questions, you know, how the design, the typical thing is for Scandinavia, but I think it's quite different. But for us from Sweden and for Dagmar, I think it is a quite clean design, I would say. But still, we work with, I mean, the base is, of course, a very high quality of everything. High quality of the fabrics, high quality of the choice of the yarns, and also we try to do high quality in the design. And what is that, you can ask, but that is for us, when it lasts long, you know. So we try to jump over the like flies or the trends and stuff like that. We try to really
create their own style, basically, not follow trends so much. Be on trend, but not follow them, perhaps.
Yeah, create a new silhouette and a new look. So we want to create a new Dagmar look.
I think she's, I mean, she's definitely a mix of us three, of course. I think it is that the woman that lives the same type of lifestyle probably that we do, quite urban woman, she likes to wear Dagmar garments, and I think she has this style that we call unconventional and sophisticated. She doesn't want to be an either or, but she wants to be both of them, and I think that's quite important, and I think that's what we try to tell with the Dagmar piece, that should be both these things together.
Yeah, I think she's very international. I think she's kind of the same. We find that she is in Stockholm, and she's in London, and she's in New York, and she's quite an urban girl, but she is quite similar. She loves the same things. She's quite updated, and but very picky with what she chooses. I mean, she's picky what she eats, she's picky where she travels, she's picky with the clothes, but and she don't want to look the same as everyone else. She kind of wants to have her own style. It's all for you. We do a lot ourselves, actually. It comes from within, inside, in a way.
Yeah, but of course, Christina, the designer, she takes out the inspiration of the collection, and we sit and talk about how we want to photo shoot this particular collection, what kind of environment we want to have it in, what suits that inspiration. So we choose the environment after we've chosen the inspiration of the collection, of course. And then what type of photographer works with that inspiration, and what model works with that inspiration. Then we usually work with the stylist, but I think Christina, especially the creative director of the company, she's always there and having her hand on like the last bits and pieces of what's leaving Dagmar. So she's kind of, I don't know, steering a bit, maybe, the stylist as well. I don't know exactly why, but I think one of the things why, maybe why fashion or why having your own style, maybe for instance, or I think the Scandinavian or Swedish design, if you look at design as a concept, has always been, if you go back in days and look at so many like furniture designers, we kind of stand for quite a lot of things, I think, these Scandinavian and Swedish designers. And I think there's great artists, great furniture designers. There's so much around this,
the creative area.
This creative area. I think that's maybe that puts also Sweden, especially, on the map a bit. because I think maybe that reflects also into the fashion scene, definitely. It's this Moroccan, well, not Moroccan theme, but it's this urban woman who lives. We see her as ourselves as well, of course. It's this woman who lives and travels quite a lot. We see in the spring collection, she moves a lot from the urban cities like New York and London, but then she goes away on holiday. She wants to have a wardrobe that works in the business meetings, in the style, in the airplane, traveling, and on the beach in, for instance, Morocco, and this type of lifestyle, and this, that we try to create the wardrobe for this woman, basically. Looks, yeah. Maybe this look, I think, is, yeah. I mean, we have this print, and this skirt especially can also move up so it becomes a tube dress, which is this look. So this creates, you can actually just wear this, I mean, all the way from the kind of resort into the urban more lifestyle, with like a jersey top and a leather jacket or something like that. We also work a lot with knitwear. I mean, that's actually kind of the core and the strength of the company. And this is, for instance, something as well, that this is like a viscose knit. This is also, we can have this as a tubular skirt, like a long skirt, but also you can have it as a tube dress. So this is also some kind of like bit of a more bohemian but yet quite strict look that we go for. So we kind of try to have these like clutches together.
And then we have a lot of spicy colors in the collection, like this spicy,
like mustardy, curry. Again, you see these kind of this knitting pattern here. It's the same here in the skirt.
You see the Moroccan in the tone.
Yeah, yeah. And here again, you can get
like
this
the look. You can touch the print also.
She's me when I went on holiday to Morocco.
What I packed. Again, here you get these t-shirts. I mean, so we go everywhere from a t-shirt down to the croco pants.
Crocodile print, really cool.
Yeah, it is actually a crocodile print, but more like...
So here's kind of like the spine, you can see. This is almost like that. If you show that on the white sweater, you can see that on the knitted sweater.
Pick it up.
Mm. Here you see again, like, it's almost like a spine on the...
And here is...
Very eco-friendly crocodile.
Yeah. And here again, this is kind of this Moroccan theme, but the caftan look. But if you have a like a lined slip or bikini on the beach, or a slip dress, you can have it to a cocktail party. So it's really this
easy.
All the time. This easy, should be easy to wear, relaxed look, but still beautiful qualities.
That's the whole. I mean, unfortunately, it's not.
Unfortunately for you, but fortunate for us.
It's quite a nice print. I mean, if you don't want to be, it's like too colorful.
Very soft.
I love this
beautiful
one. And then you have red dress here.
It's caftan, kind of,
live.
So it's again this kind of caftan look, but it's a beautiful silk and the printed silk, so it's quite luxurious, but still relaxed luxury.
You can really dress that up or down, depending on
really
the jewellery,
exactly,
shoes,
if you want to.
And a floppy hat.
Exactly, or you can just have it to like high heels on
a
great party, and then you go. So that's, I mean, that's what we like to do with our clothes, Dagmar. You can dress it up or dress it down, really, whatever you choose to wear.
Well, someone who said it was like, it was more like an LA style goes, an LA girl goes to New York.
Yeah.
She wants to be dressed, but relaxed as they are in LA. So it was kind of funny to see
the American,
how they compared it to the American style.
I mean, here again, you can also see, I think this look is quite nice. You have this long, very thin cardigan, which I think is quite nice. But then you have a pair of jeans, shorts, and just like a top underneath. So it's also dress, but it could be a very relaxed look as well.
Did you do the shoes too?
No. These, unfortunately.
Are you going to rent into accessories?
Definitely. Not now, but later on.
Absolutely.
In the future, definitely. I want to have everything.
Thank you.
it's you, it's you.